I'm going to explain a general basic idea about financial management. What is financial management and what are the other facts and important information relating to FM? There are various subjects, various areas what we study, and basically financial management is an area relating to the experts who, the people, the professionals who do their MBA in finance. It is a subject, and basically it's not only meant for MBA in finance, it is meant for CAs, it is meant for those who pursue their BCom, MCom. This is a subject. Like, what we find that a management professional or a finance professional must know, a manager, because basically when what we study, one day or another day we have to become a professional in any organization. So our knowledge, the academic knowledge and our practical knowledge plays a very important role in our jobs and the duties which are assigned to us. Now the point is, what is financial management? Look, the financial management is basically management of finance. In an organization, because generally when we are talking about financial management or marketing or human resource, in our mind a corporate world runs. How does a company function is in our mind. The business enterprises or joint stock company, what is running in our mind is our joint stock company. Like a good size, good, like means not a very small organization, a joint stock company, maybe a limited company or a listed company, a little bit bigger in size. The point, because generally, you know, when we study, we don't want to serve to a small organization, because we are looking for good pay package, we have groomed ourselves, we have learned some subjects, so we want to work with some good organization. Generally, I've seen that people give their introduction, they want that the organization should be large enough and famous also. It should be a brand so that we can say people proudly that I work for this organization. So generally once we learn FM and other subjects and we become a professional, let it be any professional having a background in the field of finance and all, then we want to serve a big organization. So that's why I'm referring to a big organization, because the finance is managed for a big organization. Because I'm not talking about a sole proprietor or a partnership firm, because they are not going to offer us a good job in the field of finance, because they manage all the things and decision making on their own. Now, so when we talk about the FM, think about a big joint stock company or any big organization. Generally, this is a form of organization where the size can be big. Otherwise, there are constraints if we are talking about some other form of business organization. So what I am explaining is relating to joint stock company or some big size organization. Fine. Now my next point is, I want to come to the topic for which I have been invited. What is FM? Basically financial management is how to manage finance. Look, for just a small introduction, I want to draw a balance sheet of a company or any organization. So keeping in mind, I'm keeping schedule 3 in mind. Let it be a balance sheet of a company. Here we have proprietors fund, shareholders fund, here we include share capital, then we have to take reserves and surplus, and here we take non-current liability, the next heading, although there is another heading but it's not very important. So here we include preference share capital and what? Equity share capital, and then we have non-current liability. We may have debentures as a source. I'm linking this. Why I'm explaining this? There is a link between financial management and this area of balance sheet, and this is my liability side. The name is equity and liability. Okay, so here I talked about share capital, preference share capital, equity share capital. It includes both. Here I have written reserves and surplus. Here I have written debentures, although it is called long term, non current liability. Then we have long term borrowings. Okay, so and here we write fixed assets, and this is a little general idea about the. This thing, the asset side, and then we have current assets. Here we have current liability. A basic general idea. So, what is the area where the financial management is mainly linked with? It is linked with the borrowing. There are various decisions which are taken in finance. How, from whom to borrow. What proportion to borrow? There is a term called debt equity ratio. I shall explain about it because it's very important decision making area relating to FM. Debt equity, composition between the two, and where to invest, how to borrow, whom to borrow, what is the composition of debt and equity, and then where to invest and how much dividend to be paid. To satisfy the contributories who have lent the money to us. So, these are the areas of decision making areas of FM. Because there are various departments in the organization, and finance is one of the main department. Beside others, there may be marketing department, there may be research and development department, there may be IT department, there may be HRM department, there may be marketing. It depends on the departmentation of an organization, their policy, how much department they can afford to and they can maintain. But I am referring to the finance department. What are their functions now? Actually, what are the areas? So, just make a link between the things, two, three things I have drawn your attention. I have drawn a balance sheet. Why? Because I want to tell you what are the items in the balance sheet where the FM has got a direct link. FM has got a direct link with share capital. We include two types of share capital, preference shares and equity shares. How to borrow, whom to borrow, in what composition to borrow. Because there is a concept I shall explain later called trading on equity, and it is another ratio called debt equity ratio. There is a proportion. This is another very important critical area of a finance manager to decide, or the finance department, if we need to borrow the money, how to make it optimum borrowing capital structure so that our weighted average cost of capital is minimum and we can get the advantage of tax. So there are very critical important areas what we decide in finance. So what are the areas which come under the purview of the finance department? They are borrowing, from whom, in what proportion, the feasibility of borrowing and composition of borrowing. These are the decisions to be taken in FM. Then where to invest. There are certain chapters called capital budgeting or capital investment decisions. And where to invest. And then how much dividend to be distributed to those who have lent us money. These are the areas of decision making we consider while taking decisions relating to financial management. So what is financial management basically? If you have a look at the few things I have brought to your consideration, there are many important things as regard to a joint stock company or any big size business organization. How much to borrow, in what proportion to borrow, and where to invest, what is return, where we are investing money. And I would like to say, to make it easy, that company is like a middleman. It borrows money. I can make one action. It borrows money from here, it invests here, then it gets return here, it gives return here. So company is there, and it takes money from preference shareholders, equity shareholders, and whom. Because these three terms, although there may be long-term financial institution and some other name, but Abhi right now I'm taking very common name, what any 11th or 12th student must know, that from where the money is borrowed. So we borrow money from preference shareholders, equity shareholders and debentures. Debentures and equity have got a composition which is called debt equity ratio. And then we invest the money in a project or a proposal, what we evaluate. And when we borrow money, there is a term called cost of capital, which is one of the very important topic of FM, which is to be taught to any professional. And then there is a composition, as I was referring again and again, one word I was drawing your attention towards, debt and equity. So that is another topic called leverage. And there is another term called trading on equity. I know all about. If I will be given opportunity, I can explain one by one all. Everything is in my mind. So now, where to invest the money? What are the projects, the proposals? Because you know, when we borrow money from those who are contributing finance, basically long-term finance, to the company, we know it has got an opportunity cost. It has got an opportunity cost. So because nobody is doing the charity that somebody is lending me money without having any cost of capital, so they have to lend money to me and I have to give them a return. So I'm the company, or I'm the board of director. I'm one of the member of board of director. So I'm borrowing the money from company I'm borrowing the money in the company, in the system, and people who are lending me, they are preference shareholder, equity shareholder, or they are whom? They are debenture holders. Then I invest the money in projects and proposals. And from these projects and proposals, I evaluate them. So there is another very important topic. The core topic of financial management is called capital budgeting or capital investment decision or some other return on capital employed. These are the terminology relating to finance. And I'm explaining what is the finance function basically and what is the role of the finance department. They borrow money from them, they invest money in the projects, they get a return, then they give return to those who contributed the money. And this is how company gets, it brings prosperity to the country, to the nation, and it provides employment. It takes money from those who want to sacrifice the liquidity. It invests the money into projects. It gets return. Lot of people get employment. There are various stakeholders whose interests are kept into consideration in taking financial decision, like bonus to be given to employees, which is one of the cost, element of the cost. Then we have to give the cost, we have to see the market price of our share, and we have to get a very good return. Because suppose if the money which is invested has got a cost of capital is on, and this is a weighted average cost of capital, is 14%, suppose, and my project gives me a return of 18%, then certainly my lenders are going to get advantage. And how, you know, the market price in the share, market price of a share of a company reflects my success story. If I'm running the business having a good financial management practices and a sound practices, certainly it will reflect in my profitability, it will reflect in my resources, my allocation, my decision making, and certainly those who are associated with me as the contributors to the share capital or the lenders, they will be happy because their investment is safe, they are getting a good return, and that will be reflected in the share, because you know, share market is something in finance which absorbs every small information. So how the prosperity of a company can be checked? It can be checked from the financial statement. I'm not saying the share market, it can be a fluke also sometime. A mistake or some other issues may be there. So how the financial, strong financial position can be judged? It can be judged through balance sheet or financial statements. It can be judged, so there are many tools. There is a very important topic called ratio analysis or analysis of financial statement. We compute lot of ratios. We look at the gravity, and there are certain areas where we check the profitability ratio. We check the ratios for investors. We check the solvency position, short term, long term, working capital ratios there are. So these are the areas and tools in financial management which tells the top management in which direction the company is moving. and whether our finance is properly managed or not. So the earning per share or market price of a share or profitability position or my financial position of last 2, 3, 4, 5 years or share market price or the profitability, and there are other things which can be visible through if we analyze all the financial statements. So these are the tools of financial management which are used to judge whether everything is well and running well as it was thought, it was sought, or it is not doing well. So these are the chapters or the tools in financial management which are used. Then there are, what are the areas where decisions are taken? Look, decisions are taken in FM relating to following areas, like sources of finance, mainly long-term finance and short-term also, for working capital need, for buying fixed assets and all, this is one area. Then capital investment decision, where to invest. Then dividend decision, how much to distribute, how much to retain. Then we have, these are the basic core areas. And then like the checking of the financial gravity, whether the financial progress which are reflected are not manipulated, they are really real ground, like, and having a good depth. These are the areas. If a person who is an expert in the field of financial management can easily find out, by if he has got knowledge of FM, he can tell us whether this company has got worth to sustain, or we should invest in this company or we should not invest. So these are the areas, and there are many more decision making, like merger, acquisition, some other strategic decision. These are finally approved first by the finance department. If finance department does not okay the possibility, then the decision is not, it cannot be implemented. So this is a general idea of finance. And then one more thing, how to decide that our finance department is functioning well? If no wrong decision, no wrong recommendations are taken, you know, if suppose we go to a doctor and he tells us which part of my body is not functioning well, then he gives me some medicine and then he gets my all the things checked through the pathologist and all my reports. The same logic we can apply in financial management, because we have ratios, we have capital budgeting decision, we have dividend decision, and we have other tools to decide whether everything is going on well in the direction. And whenever the things get stuck in an organization, we take the expert consultancy of the finance department. Sir, kindly guide us what to do in this situation relating to the management of finance. I'm not talking about which product they will tell us. It is the area of the operations manager or some other marketing manager, which product to make or not to make. This I'm not taking, not saying that these are the core areas of FM, although such type of decisions are also taken on financial aspect, but not on the engineering background or some other costing aspect and all. These are the areas of the cost accountant, or some other decision may be relating to a management accountant or some other financial expert. But mainly I'm talking about, I'm saying that the decisions which are taken relating to the composition, where to invest, what is the return, how the funds will be managed, how working capital needs will be satisfied, what is the optimum way of borrowing. So there is one aspect, I remember one word called wealth maximization. This is one of the objective of finance department. And then EPS maximization is another objective. As I told you, I have gone through the evaluation of goodwill. Suppose I'm taking another topic here. Goodwill is the criteria, always goodwill is linked to profit. If there is profitability, there is a good goodwill. If this is the area of accounting, this is something related to accounting. Like, so I'm not bringing accounting in between. I'm just giving an example to think. Here I'm saying, if wealth is maximized, it is a good signal for finance department. It means their decision making were wonderful. If EPS is good, certainly the NP of the share is good. As there are movies, suppose there are various movies, we say it has crossed 100 crore, it has crossed 500 crore. When we talk about Salman Khan or Amir Khan or some other Akshay Kumar's movies and all. Similarly, wealth maximization or EPS maximization is the hit movie of the company. Company as a movie. If company's EPS is good, its NPE is above the face value, its shareholders are really happy, the employees are happy because sometimes they are also given employee stock option plan so that they can sustain in the organization. So these are the things what is linked with financial management. This is all about. And there are lot of decisions, as I said, there are various chapters, we call them dividend policy, how the wealth can be maximized, how whether we should distribute the dividend or not, whether it makes a sense or it does it affect the market price. There are dividend policy, there is a topic called leverage, there is a concept called trading on equity, then we have working capital management, we have capital investment decision, we have ratio analysis, we have some other topics like Adito, these are the core areas. So, and there is cash flow, there is funds flow statement, wonderful subject. And a man of prudence, if he does not know about finance, then he is not a successful businessman.